From the outside, NATO's new headquarters is already an iconic landmark. But inside, it will be just as impressive in terms of its environment-friendly designs and facilities. The new HQ is integrated into Brussels urban planning, with tram, bus and train stations right next door. Those who cycle to work can put their bikes in racks near the entrance with easy access to showers. And the car park was constructed with recycled demolition materials from the old buildings on the site. The new HQ was built to be as eco-friendly as possible, with highly insulated walls and lots of windows to take maximum advantage of natural light available, which saves electricity. The 8 sloping long wings collect the rain into reservoirs, and this recycled rainwater provides 90% of the water we need for toilets, cleaning and landscaping, saving a staggering 16,000 cubic metres, or the equivalent of 20 swimming pools of water per year. The state-of-the-art heating system is partially geothermal, capturing heat from deep beneath the surface, bringing it up to the building and using it to heat the water that is circulated through the slabs in the office ceilings and through the floor of the huge central atrium. The water is pumped through the slab ceilings to maintain a steady temperature of 21 degrees, so we save energy by heating less in winter. Every little bit helps us to reduce our carbon footprint. In the offices, the lights are automatically turned off when there's no activity in the room. When they're switched on, the intensity adjusts to the light coming from outside to generate only the amount of light needed, saving on electricity. Today, NATO recycles 54% of its waste. Tomorrow, with these new facilities, we'll do even better. In its new HQ, NATO will deliver on its promise to create an eco-friendly workplace, using more of what is already available, recycling whenever we can, and wasting as little as possible.